Hi everybody, this is Justin Sparks from steampunkartsupplies.com, and I'd like to go over how to safely unwind a clock movement so that you don't damage any of the parts, and also so that you don't cause an injury to yourself. There's some large springs in some of these movements that can unwind or uncoil rather quickly, and you could end up with a trip to the emergency room if you are not careful. I'm going to go over a couple movements that you may get, and then I'm going to show you how to safely unwind them. Okay, what I have here is, I'm just going to move some of this stuff. I'll probably be working on that movement. What we have, I have a cuckoo clock movement. This one has no spring. They're driven by a weight and a chain. And if you get one of these, other than sharp edges, they're fairly safe to take apart, and you can just disassemble them and get the gears and pieces you need. We're not going to talk about that type. There's also another type that has a mainspring barrel. The springs are inside a casing, and typically, as long as they're unwound, you can take the clock apart without them spinning freely. And you can actually get cut by a gear if it spins too fast near your hand. So I can cover that later on another video on how to unwind one of these, but we're not gonna talk about this. I wanna talk about this type of movement, and this one has two springs. There's one for the time train, and there's one for the chime train. And each one needs to be unwound so that it can be safely disassembled. What we have is, I like to do the chime train first. And basically a chime train has a wheel, and each one of these notches represents an hour chime. So you've got the first hour it chimes, and each slot is a stop, and this little spring here stops in the chime. So you've got the first hour here, then it chimes twice, 2 hours, then it chimes three times, then it chimes four times, and they consecutively get larger. You can see here, if I release that, it'll chime for the number of hours for that section of the wheel. Okay, what we want is we want that to be able to spin freely and keep moving, okay? And that's the stop for that hour. So what I say to do with these, or what I typically do with these, is I just bend this little fork out and let it unwind on its own. Now there's a limiter paddle here that's just a wind resistance paddle, and you can take that paddle out and let it spin a little faster. So we can do that now. Now, safety first, right? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna use gloves and safety glasses, because as soon as you start unlimiting these springs, then you have a possibility for trouble. Before we remove those pieces, I want to show you the other portion to the spring. This is a ratchet that allows you to wind it. You put the key in there, you can see it winding and that ratchet clicking in place. Okay, I'm putting more tension on the spring now. Now if you want to unwind the spring the slow way, you got to put this movement in a vise or clamp it to your table. You put a little tension on the spring and release that ratchet, and then slowly, methodically, with your hand, with the ratchet out of the way, unwind it. And it takes a while, and you have to be very careful not to let that wheel spin or you'll damage the gears. But you can do it. You can clamp it down and unwind it by hand. It takes a lot of time, and you end up with a tired hand. I don't like doing it that way because I usually take apart several movements, and I need them to unwind on them, by themselves, so I can walk away and work on the next one. So I don't recommend that. And a lot of times people don't have a key for the clock when they get it. They'll buy a movement off of eBay. They don't end up with a key. They just end up with the movement. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put my gloves on. I'm gonna bend this tab and I'm gonna pull this paddle wheel out. So if I might be able to zoom in just a little bit here, and that way you guys can see me do the work. Um, I have had these things explode. So it's, so you know, I better to have leather on your hands rather than just bare hands. So this little tab right here, if you bend it, it's not going to fall on that limiter slot anymore. So now when it goes around, it's going to, well, I gotta bend it just a little bit more. Here we go. It's gonna just click on every single one of them. And hopefully when we get around to this notch, we'll see, it should just go right past it. There we go. So there, you could walk away right there and not touch it and let it unwind. And you could have an unwound spring in maybe an hour or so, and you can come back and safely work on the other side to get the other spring unwound. If you want to go a little faster, you can take this paddle out. Now, you can basically cut that pinion, or you can pull it out of this spot right here by just bending the plate out a little bit. Now, if you want to salvage your plate and you're not sure of yourself, you may not want to do it this way, but I just pull it out like that and it can pull right out of the plate because that plate has flex. Once you pull this out, that's your wind resistance limiter. It's gone. We can now just, you can see it's going a lot faster, and that will unwind couple times faster than it would normally. Okay, at this point I'm gonna let it unwind. Okay, so this has wound down and it's fairly loose, and it's to a point where it's not dangerous anymore. You have to be careful. It still has a little bit of tension, but it's not gonna be nearly as dangerous as it was when it was wound up. The next thing we want to do is remove the ratchet from the escapement so that we can get to allow this wheel to spin free and allow this spring to unwind on its own. So what we want to do is take that out, and there's a little wire in here that I have to get to. You don't want that thing to spin free. Typically the wire is not there. This one is kind of a bent piece. It was broken. One of the things I wanted to mention about, you know, buying an old movement is that these are old movements. Sometimes they're 100 years old, and you can't expect them to be perfect. So one of the dangers is that you can assume that everything's going to work well, and you could have a wheel come loose or something come loose, and you end up with a spring flying loose. So this should start unwinding, hopefully. Okay, there we go. So same thing. We're going to let this unwind, and it should look the same. When we're done with it, we should be able to get, we'll have a whole spring that's completely unwound. So I'll let that unwind, and then we should be ready to disassemble. Okay, so it looks like it's run down here. It's at a point where it's safe, and the next thing you can do is remove the nuts. Okay, so there's a little tension on here, but it should be safe to pull these off. You see I'm using gloves still. There you go. So, not too much. You can see it was fairly easy to get that apart. And at this point you got plenty of gears, plenty of parts, and lots of things to build your steampunk projects out of. And you've done it safely without damaging the clock or your hands. So hope this helps, and please remember to respect the strength of these springs and have fun making your steampunk projects.